हेलो चिल्ड्रन, वेलकम टू दी ऑनलाइन क्लास ऑफ इंग्लिश 2 फॉर क्लास 3। टुडे वी विल बी डूइंग लेसन नंबर 4, द रिवर बैंक। वी हैव ऑलरेडी फिनिश्ड विद द रीडिंग पार्ट एंड द एक्सप्लेनेशन, एंड आई होप यू पीपल हैव रेड द लेसन। एज आई टोल्ड यू येस्टरडे दैट यू हैव टू read the lesson at least 3 times so that you can have a thorough knowledge of the story, what is there in the lesson. Now today we will do the exercises which are there in the book, and the rest of the things, that is the difficult words, the word meanings, the question answer, the reference to context and some more questions, and the other questions which are to be done in the copy, make sentences and all that, you will get there in the school's website. Okay, so do you remember what was there in the lesson? Yes, the lesson The River Bank is all about two creatures. One is mole, the other one is rat. The mole is cleaning his house after the winter weather. After when the weather has gone, winter weather has gone, spring has come, and they are cleaning the house. Mole is cleaning the house and he feels little bored to clean the house. So he throws everything and moves out to see the outside world, and during his stay there he comes across different people, he comes across different creatures, he moves to different places, and one such place was a bank of a river. As I told you, what is a river bank? It's the two sides of the river. So while sitting on the bank of the river, he meets the rat, and the rat is little bit an open creature. He moves all about, but the mole has not moved about till now. So the rat was surprised to hear that he has not seen the nearby places and has not sat on the boat ever before. So the rat invites the mole to have a ride on the boat, which the rat is having. So they both, the rat and the mole, sit on a boat and they sail down the river. While sailing down the river, the rat tells the mole the things, the animals, the creatures which live in and around the river, the temperament, the nature of the other creatures, the rat is telling to the mole. And on the way they come across many, they see many animals like otters, badgers, moor hens, okay, and they come across, they see many other animals around. And at the end, they start with their picnic. Means whatever they had taken with them to eat and to drink, they start to have it and enjoy the time they are spending with each other. So this was the lesson. Now today we will start with the exercises. For that I will ask you to open your book on page number 25. Let me focus on page number 25. Yes. So when you open the book on page number 25, you will come across a question over here, and it is written, choose the choose the correct option. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 questions we have. We have to choose the correct option and we will put a tick mark on the correct option. Okay, so I'll start reading. What was Mole doing when the story begins? Sleeping, spring cleaning his home. What was Mole doing? Yes, the mole was spring cleaning his home. So we will put a tick to B. Sorry, we will put a tick to B. Then number two. Where was Mole's home? On a tree, under the ground. Where was Mole's home? And on a tree, under the ground. Yes, it was under the ground. So we will put a tick mark to B. Okay, then next. How did Mole come out of his home? Through a tunnel with the help of a boat. It came out through a tunnel or it came out with the help of a boat. Yes, it came through a tunnel. It came out through a tunnel. So we will put a tick mark on A. Next, number four. What had Mole never seen before? A rabbit, a river. Yes, he had never seen before a river. So we will put a tick mark on B. Number 5. What did Mole see on the opposite bank? A water rat and otter. Yes, the mole saw a water rat. So we'll put a tick mark on A. Okay, now we will turn the page. Number 6. How did Mole and the Rat travel on the river? On a ship, on a boat. Yes, they traveled on a boat. So we will put a tick mark on B. Next is answer these questions. You will get there in the website, reference to context and the other questions. Now come to page number 27. This we will do here in the book. Page number 27, we will do this in the book. Yes, number one. Now, there are certain words, we make certain words by combining two words. Okay, and both the words have different meaning. They have a different meaning. For example, white and wash. You can see there in the book, white and wash, two different words. White means a color, name of a color. Wash means an activity of cleaning. It's a verb. White is a name of a color and wash means an activity of cleaning, means verb. It's a verb. Now when we combine white and wash together, it makes a new word, that is whitewash. And this word, new word, whitewash, has a different meaning, a new meaning. Okay, has a new meaning. Now one more example. Sun plus shine. Sun means, you all know, it's a solar planetary object, big ball of fire which is there. controlling everything which is there in the solar system, and the earth and the other planets move around it. We know this sun. And the next meaning, next word is shine. Next word is shine. Shine has a different meaning. Sun is different, shine is different. Shine means something to sparkle, to twinkle kind of thing. Okay, so when we combine both the words sun and shine, it makes a new word, and that is sunshine. And sunshine has a different meaning. The other third example, underground. Underground. Under has different meaning and ground has different meaning. Both are separate words, but when we combine them, it makes a new word, and that is underground. So when we make these kind of words by combining, joining two words, we call the new word compound words. Okay, we call it compound words. For example, sun, flower, okay, these kind of words. Cup and board, cupboard, okay, these are some more examples. Now we have an exercise over here. We can see some words over here, few options given there on the other side. We have to match the red words which are there, main words, with the options given, with the correct option. Okay, with the correct option. Now number one is sun, number one is sun, and the option given is flower, glass, pen. Yes, sun plus flower, sunflower. So we can make a word. So circle the word. We can make a word out of flower plus sun. So we will circle the word flower. Circle the word flower. Okay, circle the word flower. Then sun, sun plus glass, sun plus glasses. There is a new word, sunglasses. And that is a new word, meaningful word. So we will circle the word glasses. Next, bath. Bath box, bathtub, bathrobe. So bath plus tub makes bathtub, and bathrobe combines. Bathrobe, bath and robe combined together makes bathrobe. So these two words, meaningful words. Book, shelf, pot, case. So book is the main word. We have to combine shelf with it. Yes, book, shelf is a meaningful word. Book pot, there is no word book pot. Then book case, there is a meaningful word book case. So we will circle the word shelf and case. Fire, next word, number four. Fire, place, fire, fighter, fire, water. So fireplace makes a word, and firefighter makes a word. Okay, so we will circle place and fighter. Number five, sum is the main word. We have to combine sum with note, one, where. So some note, there is no meaningful word like some note. Someone, there is new word made, someone. So we will circle one, or anyone, we will circle it. Then where, somewhere, we will circle where. Then wash room, wash is the new word. Wash room, basin, ball. Wash room, yes, washroom makes a new word combined together. Wash basin makes a new word when combined together. Wash ball, there is no word like wash ball. Then sand, number seventh word is sand. Sand, castle, sand store, sand straw. So sand castle, when combined with castle, it makes a new word, compound word, meaningful word, that is sand castle. And sand store, there is no sand store kind of word. Sand storm is a meaningful word when combined together. So we will circle castle and storm. Grand, number 8. Grand, ball. Grand, mother. Grandfather. So yes, when grand combined with mother, it makes grandmother. When combined with father, it makes grandfather. So this is one exercise of yours. Now we will turn the page to page number 28. Page number 28. Yes. Again, read these words. Picnic, basket, water, rat, river, bank. Here you can see that the words that are red in color are nouns, and they have been used as adjective to support the other noun. For example, basket. What kind of basket it is? It is picnic basket. What kind of rat it was? It was a water rat. Okay? And so on. So now, here in this exercise, you have to fill these blanks with nouns suitable. You have to fill with adjectives. Sorry, we have to fill with adjectives that can go with these nouns. Okay, you have to fill with adjectives. Now, number one says jam. Number one says jam. So what we will fill? Jam, fruit jam, apple jam, mango jam. You can fill with apple. So here write apple, apple jam. Then number two, burger. Burger, cheeseburger. We have to write here cheeseburger. Cheeseburger. Ice cream, strawberry ice cream, vanilla ice cream, any flavor we can write here. So we will write here vanilla. Vanilla. Vanilla ice cream. Opener. Opener. Bottle. Opener. Okay. Then game. Number 5. Game. Football game, cricket game, hockey game, badminton game, any game. So we will write here cricket, cricket game. Okay, cricket game. Then number 6, holder. Holder. Okay, holder. What we can we write here? Holder. What holder? Remote holder. Or what holder can we write here? We can write here like toothbrush holder. Toothbrush holder. Okay. Then number 7. Number 7. Mark. M-A-R-K. Mark. Okay. Black mark, red mark. We can write here question mark. We will write here question mark. And good option. It is a good option, question mark. Number 8, accident. Okay. Bus accident or a truck accident. Then number 9. Number 9. Dash animal, land animal, and water animal. So we will write here water, water animal. Number 10, part, part. we can write here body part, no? Body part. We will write here not anything else, but we will write here body part. My body part. Okay. Then tree. Tree. Mango tree. Apple tree. Neem tree. Okay. Any name we will give. Okay. So we will write here. We have already written apple. So we will write here mango. Mango tree. Number 12, dash tennis, dash tennis, it's table tennis. So all these words are actually nouns, but when put together with like this, they act as adjectives, they act as adjectives. Okay, so this is your one exercise. Now, come to page number 29. Come to page number 29. Here, we will read this. What is given there on the top? The mole was friendly neighbor. Here you can see red color, this thing, friendly word, red with red color, friendly. Next is mole could feel the fresh air and sunshine. Fresh. All the red words, okay. All morning, the mole had been cleaning his little home. Little. Then a small face appeared. Small. He had a brown little face. Brown. He hauled up a little blue and white boat. Blue and white. The boat was just right for two animals. Two. It was a wooden boat. Wooden. Now all these red words, friendly, fresh, little, small, brown, blue and white, two, wooden, these words are all adjective words. What are these? These are adjective, and these adjectives tell us about some noun. They tell us about the quality, quantity, size, shape, color, number, and so on. Okay, so you can see what kind of neighbor he was. He was a friendly neighbor. How was the air? The air was fresh. What was the size of the home? It was little. Okay, and so on. So next exercise in our book says this. Now you will read these lines and underline the adjective first, and then you will tell the function of each. Means you have to tell whether the adjective is of quality or quantity or number or size or of color or of material and so on. Okay, so number one says he is an honest man. So here he is an honest man. What kind of man he is? The answer is honest. So honest is adjective, so we will underline honest. Okay, honest. So he is an honest man. Honest is adjective. Now we will write the function. What kind of man he is? So we are taking out the quality of the person. So here we will write quality. So we will write here quality. She ate two burgers. She ate two burgers. Here we are underlining two. We have to underline two. Two is the number. Two is the adjective. How many burgers she has eaten? She ate two burgers. So two, number. Two is indicating the number. Two. The word two is telling the quantity of burgers the person has eaten. So number, it is telling the number. They are nice people. They are nice people. What kind of people they are? They are nice people. So we will underline nice. And what function it is telling? It is again telling quality. it is telling quality. Then next is number 4. She wore a red dress. She wore a red dress. What kind of dress she wear? What kind of dress she wear? She wore a red dress. So red is the adjective, underline red, and what is it telling? The function, it's telling color. It is telling color. She wore a cotton dress. She wore a cotton dress. Again, here cotton will be underlined. Cotton will be underlined, okay? And cotton will come under which this thing? What function? Material. Okay? Material. What kind of dress it was? It was a cotton dress. Material. Okay? He is a young man. What kind of man he is? He is a young man. So we will underline young, and the function is quality. Quality. We are taking out the quality of the person, man. The team has 11 players. The team has 11 players. How many players do the team? How many players does the team is having? The team is having. The team has 11 players. 11, we will underline 11. And write here number. We will write here number. Then she put the letter in she put the letter in a square envelope. She put the letter in a square envelope. What kind of envelope it was? It was a square envelope. So we will underline square, and it is telling us about shape. It is telling us about shape. S-H-A-P-E, shape. Okay, so with this we finish this exercise also. Then we will come to page number 3030. Okay, now spelling, to understand the spelling, just in the previous page, read these words, F-R-I-E-N-D-S, F-R-I-E-N-D-S, F-I-E-L-D-S, fields, F-R-I-E-N-D-S, friends, F-I-E-L-D-S, fields, N-E-I-G-H-B-O-U-R, neighbor. These words have E-I or I-E in them. For example, see here in the word friends, we have I-E. Fields, we have I-E. But in neighbor, we have E-I. We have E-I. Let us understand the rule when the word has I-E or E-I. Okay? I-E or E-I. See here. I before E. I before E. F-R-I-E-N-D and C-H-I-E-F. Except C. When there is a alphabet C before C is there, they will change. E will come before I. So it will be C-E-I-L-I-N-G, ceiling, and R-E-C-E-I-V-E, receive. Or when the sounding like O, sounding of O, neighbor, way, when the sound is like of A, A and Y together makes A. So here, nay, neighbor, nay, way, A, egg, egg. Sound is coming. N-E-I-G-H-B-O-U-R W-E-I-G-H way. Now, but there are some exceptions such as either foreign, height, leisure there. Okay, these are some exceptions. Now take the correct spelling. We have to take the correct spelling now. T-H-I-E-F or T-H-E-I-F? T-H-I-E-F, thief. This is the correct one. Ceiling. Already we have studied here. C-E-I-L-I-N-G or C-I-E-L-I-N-G. So this first one is correct. C-E-I-L-I-N-G is the correct spelling of ceiling. Believe. B-E-L-I-E-V-E. Believe. Believe. Okay, this one is the correct spelling. E-I-G-H-T-8 or I-E-G-H-T-8? E-I-G-H-T-8 is the correct spelling. P-E-I-C-E or P-I-E-C-E? Piece. Piece, that means to break the thing into different parts. So P-I-E-C-E, piece. The second one is correct one. F number six. F-E-I-L-D, field, or F-I-E-L-D, field. So F-I-E-L-D, field is the correct one. R-E-C-I-E-P-T, receipt. R-E-C-I-E-P-T or R-E-C-E-I-P-T, receipt. The second one, that is R-E-C-E-I-P-T. Okay, this one is correct. Receipt, because we have a C over here. Now we have C over here. So what we studied, if the word is having C before the I-E or E-I, the E will come first. Okay, so this one is correct. This one. Diesel. Diesel. D-I-E-S-E-L or D-E-I-S-E-L. This one. D-I-E-S-E-L. Diesel. Next is achieve. Achieve. A-C-H-I-E-V-E. A-C-H-I-E-V-E or A-C-H-E-I-V-E. Which one? This one. First one. A-C-H-I-E-V-E. Achieve. Now, next is deceive. D-E-C-E-I-V-E. Deceive. Or D-E-C-I-E-V-E. Deceive. Which deceive? The first one is correct. D-E-C-E. I-V-E, deceive. So we have C here now. Before I, here in achieve, the C here, I is coming first. Why? But there is C in the word, but it is not immediately before the I-E or E-I. It has H in between. So it doesn't matter over here. That rule we will not follow of having E-I. It will be IE. Okay. Here we have to follow the rule. DEC. So E will come first, not I. Okay. Immediately after C. We have to see immediately after C, the alphabet C. So DECE, IVE will be the correct one. Got? So with this, we finish the exercises which are there in the book. I will also give the answers of these exercises in the website. If you have not done it right now, you can follow it on the website and do the exercises and write the answers in the book. And rest of the answers you will get in the website, school's website. And you can copy it down as I have already told you how to do your work. Okay, first you will write the name of the lesson, put the date, first number, lesson number 4, under that riverbank, name of the lesson. Then on the left hand side, the margin, you will write difficult words. You will write all the 10 difficult words. Then on the next page, you will write the word meaning, draw proper line in between, and then write. and then start with the question answers. After each set of question and answer, you have to leave at least 3 lines and draw. If it is possible, take a blue pencil, color pencil, and draw and scale and draw a line in between. But whether you are drawing a line or not, you have to leave 3 lines. Count 3 lines and leave. That is mandatory. That is compulsory. You have to leave 3 lines after each set of question and answer. While after finishing the answer, you have to count the next immediate 3 lines, 1, 2, and 3, and then on the 4th line you will start with the next question. Okay. With this we finish the chapter, lesson number 4. But your homework till now will be to read the lesson as many times as you can. Okay, read the lesson as many times as you can, because without reading you will not understand. You have to read. If you come across some difficult words, you are unable to pronounce, you are unable to read, your parents are there, just go and have the help of your parent. Okay, so with this we finish the lesson. So meet you in the next class. Till then, bye. God bless you.